Hey guys, it's Mr. Crayfish, and today I'm going to show you guys how to create a working shell. Now, if you're from my main channel, you would have known that I did a video where I showcased a working shell. Well, in this video, I'm actually going to be doing a tutorial for that, and it's actually using command blocks. Now, I would say this is a more of a basic contraption because it's got a really small amount of command blocks. So, if you're not that good with command blocks, this is probably a good starter tutorial for you. But anyway, let's go ahead and let's get into this now, and we're going to start just by building the actual kind of shower head. Now, you can change this however you like, but the one thing you probably most want to use is one of these skeleton heads, and then I think that should be fine. So we're going to place a item frame 3 blocks up here, and then we're going to put a skull inside there, and then what we want to do is place a block under the item frame there, place a skeleton skull backwards like that, so the face is facing into the wall so we don't see it, and then now it looks like we've got some sort of shower head here. Then we might also just quickly get some of these white stained glass panes here and put them on the left and the right here, just to kind of indicate like a shower cubicle. But there we go, that's it so far, and now we're actually going to get into the actual commands of this, because if you've watched the original video, basically water will drip down from here, but if you actually go into the shower when you're on fire, it's actually going to put you out. So we need to basically handle all those functions in the commands here. Now, I've already got a little room below me here, but let's just go ahead and let's just cover this up a little bit. But there we go. So we're first going to start... Oh, actually, we need a button here. So grab out a stone button here. Pop that on the wall just behind, under the shower head there. And what we need to do is we need to test this button if it's pushed in. So we can do that by having a repeating command block here. So you have to do a command here. So give... Mr. Crayfish command block, oops, not computer, command block, place that down, and then we're going to change that to a repeating, and then make it to always active here. Then we need to type in a command here, so I'm going to go back up the top here, we need to do, well, look at the button here, then we're going to do test for block, and then press tab 3 times and it'll get the coordinates of the block we're looking at, which is the button. And then we're going to do stone button and then powered equals true, so it has to be pressed in. Copy that command, paste it into here, press done. Then we're going to get a comparator here, have that coming out of it. Then whenever it's pressed, it's going to send out a signal into the comparator, then when it's not, the comparator is going to turn off. Now we need to create a T flip-flop here, because basically when we press it on, the water will come on. When we press it again, the water will turn off. So how we do that is we need another command block here, and this one's just going to be a normal impulse one, and it's also going to need redstone. But what we need to do is simply just go /blockdata on itself. So we need to do these special characters here. It's basically the key above your tab key, and then press shift and press that, and it will come up with these little squiggly lines. Then we need to modify the data here and go success count 1. Now why this will work is because basically the success count is currently 0, but when we update it to 1, it will say, okay, that was correct. We also need a comparator coming out of it here, but it will, the success count is currently 0. When we update to 1, that's successful. When it tries to do this again, because success count is already 1, it's going to fail and then put success count back to 0, which turns off. So each time you press that button here, it's going to change this output here. So as you can see, it's on. Press it again, and now it's off. So that's our T flip-flop. So now, once this comparator here is going to be turned on, we're going to start spawning some particles coming from this shower head here. So we're actually going to use a repeating command block here. but then also make it needs redstone. Then we're going to do a particle here. Now this is where it can get a little difficult, but all commands in this tutorial are provided in the description below. But what we're going to do is we're going to let's just get this up for a sec. Okay, I'm just going to clear the chat. Alright, so what you want to do is look at the skull head here. I'm going to do particle drip water, then get the coordinates of that. Then we're going to do 0.1, 0, 0.1, and then 5. Now this might not be correct, we'll just check it here for a second here. So if we pop the command into here real quickly, then we'll be able to see where the water is actually coming from. Now as you can see, this is like completely wrong, and this is where we've got to adjust a couple of things. Alright, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to grab the command from the description below. So this is the one I used in the original, and then I'm just going to shift this over. You could probably use this as well, just update the coordinates and then update the positions. But it should look like this, where it actually spreads out. I'm not sure why it wasn't doing that, which is kind of weird. But let's move that over so it's just 1, 2 in the positive X direction. So that should be there. And then it looks like that is all good and dandy now. So the water is coming on when the shower's on. If you press the button again, that is now turned off. But now we actually want to test if there is a play in the shower that is on fire. So what we're going to do here, command block down coming out of this particle here, change it to a chain, and then also make it always active. We're simply going to place a block under the button here, look at it, then go test for at E, so an entity. Now I don't think the player selection actually works here when testing for the fire, but go at entity, square brackets, and then do type equals player. Then we're going to do X equals, now we're actually going to copy that for a second here. Clear our chat by F3 and pressing D. Then we're going to look at our looking at coordinates there. So I'll put an arrow up just so you guys can see. Then we need to pop in those coordinates, so negative 2, 3, 8. Then Y equals 69, and then Z equals 305. Then we're going to do RX equals 1, RY equals 1, RZ equals 1, and that's just going to check if there's a player inside this block here. Copy that. Actually, we're not finished yet. We need to check for the fire MBT data. So right at the end, curly brackets, type in fire, colon, and then press enter negative 20s. Basically, when it's negative 20, it means that the player isn't on fire. Because we don't really know, there's a thing where fire pretty much can last. We don't know what the value might be of fire. We only know when it is the player is not on fire, and that is going to be negative 20s. So we have to use that instead. Now we actually need to test if a player is there again without the fire tick, because pretty much this statement here saying, is there a player on fire at this location? There is two cases that will break this, and then there's one that will work. So right now, there is a player here, but they haven't got the fire tick, or they're not on fire. And if I move away, there's not a player there, and that's false again. The only time that this is kind of like true is if there's a player there. So we have two falses and one true. So we've actually got to test if a player is there, but then also test if they have a fire tick. Hopefully you understand that. And if you want, you can test it without doing this extra check, and you'll see why it doesn't actually work. Now, we also need to do conditional here. Conditional. So we've got another command, chain command here, always active. And then we're going to do exactly what this is, copy that. Pop that into there, but then just remove the MBT tag data at the end there. Then we're going to go this way and then conditional again. And then what we need to do is check if this chain command block here is false. So this is when there is a player inside the shower that is not on fire. If this is false, that means there is a player in the shower that is on fire. So we need to check for that. So we're going to look at it. Testfor block. And tab three times to get the coordinates of it. Then this is a chain command block. We don't care about the block state, so we do -1. But then we do care about what the success count is, which has to be 0 if there is a player, oopsie, if there's a player in there which has no, which is not on fire. So success count 0, copy that, pop it into this command block. So if that is true, what we need to do now is actually set the water and then set the air. So coming out of this chain here, we're going to go to that way. And if this is happens to be true, so this is going to be powered if there is a player in the fire, if there's a player in the shower that is on fire. So it's going to output here. Then what we're going to do is make this go into a command block here, just a normal impulse one that needs redstone. And then what we're going to do is set the block under the button here to water. So set block at that location, water, copy that, pop it in here. And then a repeater going this way, command block, copy this command out, but instead of water, we're going to change it to air. So this should work, and we'll test it out right now. So if we turn the shower on, okay, slight little glitch, but let's have a look what the problem with that was. So I think it's something to do with we just lost those, hold up. Ah, yes, oops, okay. So I did RZ, it's actually DX, DY, and DZ. So you've got to change those around real quickly. That's probably why. Thought it was radius. So there we go, diameter. We might not actually need to check for that now, so I officially turn this on. Okay, it seems to be still setting those up, but let's just fix that up. Not too much of a problem. Again. So I think I'm actually here. This is actually getting powered when it goes into that, so we're actually going to move that over here. So a good way to quickly move command blocks is press Control, then pick block. So you can copy the data. So that goes there. Repeater. And then the other command block. So that should be good now. Let's turn it off. Double check it doesn't do it. Alright, so there we go. Water is not being placed anymore. And I solved that problem. And then if we actually go ahead and we set ourselves on fire, but we also have to be in... So we have to be in survival mode here. Let's go ahead, place our flint and steel down here. Get burnt for a little bit here. We hop in the shower. We are still getting burnt. So let's figure out what that problem is. So doesn't look like this outputted anything. Doesn't look like this outputted anything. As you can see here, it's saying that is incorrect. So... it looks like I've actually used the player command here. So instead of up here, where is that? And okay, that's correct. This one here has to be unconditional because this won't run at all if this one's not true. And this one we want to not be true. So remove that one. And then if we actually go ahead and do this again, just be careful here. There we go, the water spawned and then despawned and actually put us out. And then we can go ahead and turn this off. And there we go, that is the working shower. Hopefully you guys learned how to build this today. Again, all the commands are in the description below. But I'll go for a quick overview again of how this all works. So first of all, let's go to game mode C. We check if the button is true. If it is, we're going to do a T flip-flop here using a blockdata command. So this will flick on and off as you press the button here. If it's on, then spawn the water. Check if there is a player there that is not on fire. So if there's a player there that's not on fire, then we also test if there is a player there without any sort of data tags. Then this one is checking if this command block here is false. If it is, that means there is a player there on fire, because here we're checking if there's not. If that's not true, then there is a player there. So we go ahead and we just spawn water, and then one tick later we spawn air just to replace it and not have it go everywhere. But that is it, guys. Hopefully you enjoyed this tutorial today. I do have more coming for the other contraptions that I've got in this world, such as the alchemy station out the back there, and then I think the other one, I forgot what the other one was. I think we've already done the other one. Yeah, that was the tool rack. But yeah, that's it. I will see you guys later. Hopefully you enjoyed. More to come on this channel. Bye! And I broke it.